Hi guys, my name is Nicolette Mashile. I am also known as the Financial Bunny. Welcome to the Financial Bunny TV. Today we're talking all things rental investments and why they are not the land of milk and honey that we've been made to believe. Now remember that none of my videos constitute as financial advice. If you are looking for financial advice, please speak to somebody who is certified and registered with the FSCA. Now today's video is brought to you by Buka Tata Idata, and Buka Tata Idata is a revolutionary way in which all of us can save some money when it comes to our data issues. Now of course you guys know that I've been doing financial coaching, and most of my clients, where I see on their budgets when I ask them to send me their bank statements, is the fact that they spend so much money on data. And I think because a lot of people don't really know how much data they need at the beginning of the month, it is difficult to allocate a certain amount of data every single month on your budget. So a lot of people, what they do is they don't buy data in bulk, but what they do is they buy every single time they need it. But what happens is that a lot of people then end up paying so much in banking fees because they're buying data almost every single day. Now you've probably got a Wi-Fi router in your house, then you're buying data, then you're buying airtime, and just that cost just almost accumulates so much that it becomes really not financially savvy to be able to buy data. So what if I told you that you do not need to buy data anymore? However, just a little bit of your time could be able to give you the data that you need every single month by simply watching ads on the Buka app. It's a mobile app that you can download, and what you're going to find there is you're going to find content, and on that content there will be ads, just like similar to YouTube, right? However, YouTube would only pay the content creator. Now, you as somebody who's also subscribed to a certain person's content would also be repaid by data. Absolutely revolutionary, right? So let's get into today's video. As I said, hey, let me tell you, it is tough that side by rental properties, especially right now when we are in a global financial crisis. So let me tell you what happened, right? So one of my first apartments that I bought is a loft, beautiful loft. It's got a 2-bedroom, it's got 2 living spaces, it's got a patio. You oversee the whole of Johannesburg North from it. It is in a well sought out estate. It is well taken. The way I know my estate is well taken care of, they give me stress because some of my tenants have cars that leak oil. They will count the amount of bricks that have oil leaks on them, and they will send an email and say, hi, Miss Machine, hi, please note that you have 10 bricks that have oil leaks in your carport. Please get this fixed in the next couple of days. We're giving you 10 days or else we're going to fix it and charge it to your rates account. So I know for a fact that that estate is so well taken care of because of simple things like that. The other day they sent us an email because one of my tenants left their rubbish on the floor inside the designated rubbish area, instead of putting it inside the bin. Mind you, it was in a black plastic bag, but because the little kid took it, and she could not reach the bin, so she put it on the ground, and they were like, oh my god, it's gonna create an infestation, I'm gonna have maggots and all. And I was like, yay, you guys are very strict, eh? So you want to move into those strict estates. But however, I got one of those lofts, and when I got it, I think I got it in 2015, right? And it was doing really well because I got it with a tenant. So my tenant was there. After a year, we increased the rent. So the rent went up eventually to obviously the market related rent of that specific estate of similar units like the one that I've got, right? So at that time, it was, at the last tenant that moved out, and she moved out at the beginning of this year, we were sitting at a rental, I think, of 10,000 rand, if I'm not mistaken, 10,000 rand without electricity and without access to the gate. So anyway, here I am. I'm like, okay, I've got a vacant a loft. It shouldn't be difficult. It's one of the best. You know, it shouldn't be difficult for me to rent out. So I go out. 10,500 is my starting listing rental amount. Oh, by the way, I hired a real estate agency to assist me, you know, in finding the right tenant, because I have been burnt before where I found the tenants myself and they are just delinquents, right? So they were using TPN, they were using all sorts of systems to be able to find me the right tenant. And eventually they found the right tenant. Oh, no. So hold on. Before they find the right tenant, she sends me an email to say, listen, Nicolette, actually the 10,500 that you are listing it at is a bit high. We're not getting any leads. We're not getting any hits on this thing. Can I bring it down? I'm like, sure, okay, it's not a problem. Please bring it down to 9,500. So she brings it down to 9,500. After 2 weeks, he comes back to say to me, Nicolette, we're still not getting any hits. We're still not getting any leads. You know, people are very conscious of how much they're going to pay on their rent. And currently we're sitting with a problem because nobody is interested in the apartment. Of course, you know, my emotions are now skyrocketing because I'm thinking about the rates that I need to pay, the levies that I need to pay, and all sorts of things that I need to pay, and to make sure that this place is actually profitable, because I mean, that's the reason why you invest in rental property, right? You want your property to be actually profitable. Luckily for me, I do not have a bond on it, so thank goodness for that, right? Okay, Chef Case, no problem. Eventually, after like 4 weeks, she says to me, Nicolette, could we bring down the rent to 8,000 rand? I've got somebody that is interested, but she's also looking at other apartments, and currently it's the price or the rental amount that she is struggling to pay, and she really loves your place, but she can't sign a lease because there's somewhere else where she may potentially pay cheaper. And I was like, oh my goodness, 8,000 rand, from 10,500 to 8,000 rand. That's a 2,500 rand knock that I've had to take on that apartment. Okay, so I'm like, okay, that's fine. You know what? There's nothing that I can do. It's okay. I'm okay with it. Let's go with the 8,000 rand. Then I'm like to them, okay, can you manage this thing for me? Because you know what? Actually, I need somebody to take over my properties. If this is the start, let's start with this one. Guys, let me tell you, managing your own properties is got the most amount of stress that you will ever imagine. However, let me tell you, it is far more profitable than getting a management agency. And maybe it's because it's the first time I'm using a management agency and I'm not really sure what the benefits are yet. I hear what they're going to do for me. I mean, so one of the services that they've got is placing the tenant for me, managing the tenant's issues. So they become literally the contact person for the tenant. It's no longer me. So if there's a burst geyser, all of those things, they will be able to facilitate, which, to be quite honest, these things don't just come up all the time. So if you actually like looking at the pros and cons of whether to manage it yourself or manage it, have a managing agency, for me, I don't know if those issues come up enough times for you to actually justify having a letting agent manage your property. Then the other thing that they are giving me as a service is they're going to pay my rates. So I'm giving them my account, they're paying the rates to City of Johannesburg and to the levies, obviously, to the estate, to the management agency that manages the whole estate, right? So those are some of the things that they're going to be doing for me. Again, I don't know if it justifies, especially because their actual rent or management commission is 10% of your monthly rent plus I think it's 10% of the full amount. So they take the first month's rent, then they also take 10% every single month. Although I actually negotiated it down to 8% because I was like, 10% every month. Hey, I'm the papaya here, because wow, how much am I actually really going to be left with? So my tenant apparently paid 3 months rent. So that is April, May, June, right? So 3 months rent, if you take 8,000 rand, you multiply it by 3, you get what is it? 24,000, right? And then she also then paid for deposit. So technically she paid for 4 months. So she pays deposit. So it's 8, 16, 24, 32. So she paid 32,000 rand in total. Now, this is for 3 months, remember. So they're taking 8,000, they're putting it into an interest-bearing account because it's a deposit. Then they take another 8,000 for placement, so placing the tenant, right? Now I'm only left with 16,000. From the 16,000, they need to minus the rates and taxes of this month, right? They need to minus, which come up to like 3,000. The rates, the levy is like 3,000, and then City of Johannesburg takes like 800. So that's like, let's just round it off to 4,000. So they take 4,000 rand from that 16,000, right? That's left. So already I'm left with 12,000 rand, right? You can already see what's happening here, guys. Guys, kunzima. Like, it's really not worth. This is 3 months, by the way. So technically, I'm not going to get any more rental from her other than her paying her electricity and her paying her access for the next 3 months, basically. So for the next 3 months, I need to work on that 16,000. So let's say we minus 4,000 for April for rates. Then we minus another 4,000 rand for May. Then we minus another 4,000 rand for June. That's 12,000 rand. So essentially, in the last 3 months, I'm going to make 4,000 rand. Basically, 4,000 rand plus, of course, her electricity for 3 months, right? Or 2 months. Yeah, for 2 months that she's going to pay. Because that, I guess, if I'm paying 3,000, it means that I'm paying with her electricity. So it means that her electricity is like 1,000 rand every single month. So it will be 1,000 rand for the next 2 months. So it will be 4,000 plus 6,000 rand that I would have made as profit up until June. Yeah. Oh, and then of course it's minus the 8% every single month that I have to pay for the management of the apartment. So I'm just here to tell you guys that it's not really all that it's cut out to be. So that actually made me sit down and actually calculate how much money is. Are my apartments actually really making for me? Of course, anything in life is a scale business. So the more apartments that you've got, the better it is. I don't know if they give you a discount if you have like 5 or 6 or 7 or 8 or 10 apartments with them that they're managing. But as it stands now, it looks like they actually charge you per apartment. So it's 10% per one apartment, 10% per next apartment, 10%. So I'm not really sure how it becomes something that... I mean, to be quite honest, for the last 5 years, I have been managing 5 apartments. And there are days, obviously, when maybe somebody's geyser bursts, or maybe, you know, this one needs a pipe has burst, or there's mold in the bathroom. So those are some of the issues that really come up. Every single month when I do my rates and taxes or and pay COJ for my house, I do all of them. So I do all the apartments, I do my house, I do my domestic. So I pay all my payments or go through in one on one day. So I've done that. So on the management side, in terms of admin, I don't think it's a lot. I don't think it's worth it. It's simply when you have issues, like I've had issues where I've had to evict someone, and that has been obviously a nightmare. And I don't know if the managing agency really would manage that, to evict somebody on your behalf without charging you additional costs over and above what they already charge you as a management cost. So yeah, look, and that's what I wanted to say in this video, that, you know, real estate and property investment, especially rental property, I personally, where I stand, and maybe it's just today, and because the world of finance is upside down right now, it's something that I would say go in there cautiously, be very, very clear on what the profits that you're going to make. Because let's be fair, 3 of my properties are bought cash. So on average, I paid, let's say, 900,000 for each one. That's 900,000. 9 times 3 is 18, 27. That's 2.7 million rand that's currently tied up in buildings. And if we're being fair, the amount that I get back every single month from 2.7 million that's currently sitting in brick and mortar, I don't think it's enough. Personally, I don't think it's enough. And I think it's worth you. And by the way, these are my properties bought cash. Now, you can imagine for some people, their investment properties are also bonded. So not only are you paying the bond, you're also paying the interest over the bond. It's just a lot, guys. I don't know. I think there may be better investments. Yes, of course, you do need to have property within your investment strategy. But I think there might be a better way to do it. And that's currently what I'm really, really researching now, is to invest my property where I don't need to worry about the management. I just collect my rent. Somebody else pays the rates and taxes. Somebody else pays the levies. I just collect my rent, okay? And that rent needs to be 10% of the purchase price. It does not make sense for me to be paying. Yeah, I don't know, guys. Like, I'm stressed. And I'm hoping that you guys are going to give me some sort of comments in the comment section that may assist me. Remember, my video today is brought to you by Booka app. It is a data incentivized app where you watch advertisements And they call it advertisement. Yes, you watch ads, and for every single ad that you watch, you actually get awarded with data. Really worth it if you're a student, if you are somebody that is very data conscious, if you're somebody that can't afford data, or somebody that when they go through their bank statements realizes how much data they actually are spending. But anyway, watch content. So as I said, this may be a great place for you to kind of explore.